Thank you very much. Thank you. Dale, with your permission, before I begin, I would like to, clear up a little myth that has surrounded magicians for centuries, and that is that they have been accused of concealing things up their sleeves, which is really ridiculous when you think about it. Well, I suppose if a magician were to take handkerchief, such as this one, show it on both sides, and then pull up both sleeves, showing his hands empty, and then reach underneath that handkerchief and produce, let's say, a wristwatch, well, maybe it could have come from his sleeve. But if he were to reach under that same handkerchief and produce a wine glass, well, that would be a horse of a different color, because obviously there's not room in your sleeve for a wine glass, and even if you could find a spot for that, there certainly wouldn't be room for the bottle. So much for the sleeve theory. You know, there have been many, many magicians on the Magic Palace here, and I am one who firmly believes that every show such as this should have a little bit of variety. I have taken it upon myself tonight to supply that much-needed variety, and I am going to teach everybody here in the studio, and you at home as well, exactly how to juggle. Try to control yourselves, please. Let me explain. I know we probably don't have a lot of experienced jugglers in the group, so we're going to start out with the basics, the very simple two-hand juggling. Oh, boy. Yes. Now, if you want to be a juggler, the most important thing to learn is what we in the business call the single revolution, as opposed to the double revolution. I see we don't have time tonight for the triple revolution. I'm sorry, it's a beautiful sight. But if you want to become a really proficient juggler, you're going to have to learn to be ambidextrous in your right hand as well as your left hand. The single revolution in the right hand, in the left hand. Ooh. As you can see, it's not all peaches and cream for your instructor up here. I hope it won't take away from the actual juggling if I wear my juggler's nose guard. Un momento. Perfect. The single revolution in the right hand, in the left hand, in both hands, in neither hand. Thank you. Now, I want to stop here for just a moment. Now, this will just take a second. I have to tell you what happened to me when I flew up here to Canada. I came from California, as Dale mentioned. This is a true story, I promise you, really. I was at the airport in Los Angeles, and if you've been to one recently, you know about the electronic security system that they have, right? There's a little sort of an archway affair, and everyone has to walk underneath this thing. You know what I'm talking about. Well, I'm standing in line there with everybody else, minding my own business. And as I'm standing there, I notice a sign that they have posted in the airport. And believe it or not, this sign says, "Illegal to carry arms aboard plane." I couldn't believe it. I figured these guys are really cracking down. Well, I didn't want to make a scene. So before I got to the front of this line, I called the girl over. I explained to her that I had some arms in my bag. Well, she got very excited and called over a policeman, if you can believe this. And the policeman says, "All right, what kind of arms are you carrying?" And I said, "They've been sawed off." He tears open my bag, spreads everything out on the floor. He tells me to take out the arms and throw them down on the floor. So, I threw them down. He said, "What's that?" I said, "That's my act." He said, "You're crazy." I said, "Oh, you've seen my act." Well, he took everything, stuffed it back in my bag, and sent me right on through. I'm telling you, there are a lot of strange people out there. But you folks have come here today to learn how to juggle. So, after you have mastered the art of throwing up two objects, you're ready for the much more difficult, I've got one more, three-hand juggling. I I am an equal opportunity employer. Right on, right on. Please, please. I'd like to begin with some very simple hand balancing, and then we're going to move into the much more difficult, and you can all try this when you get home, three-hand juggling. Maestro, music. Difficult. Behind the back.